Hey there YouTube, Engineering is Magic, back again with another video. So as a lot of you in the YouTube cannabis community know, there's been a lot of bad news recently coming from the federal government and especially the Obama administration cracking down on medical marijuana in California and around the whole country. So today I'm going to bring you a quieter episode of that, which has been brought around by the ATF, which is the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. So this branch of the government, which sounds like it should be a redneck gas station somewhere in the middle of Alabama, is actually issuing a letter to say that if you are a medical marijuana patient, you are not legally allowed to own a gun. You're not legally allowed to exercise your Second Amendment right. So although in California here and in Washington, gun rights were important as a civil rights issue, I have to give it up to the folks of Montana, where it's a real cultural issue, and both the medical marijuana patients and the gun advocates have agreed, and the state has agreed, that what the ATF is trying to do is really unconstitutional. It does violate the Second Amendment. So today I'm vaporizing a little strawberry cough that I got from Harborside, and I'm gonna be vaporizing it here in the volcano. So like I was saying, basically the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms says that anybody who uses marijuana, legally or illegally, medicinally or not, is a drug addict and not eligible to purchase or own a weapon for self-defense. This is just complete and utter bullshit. So although I don't own any guns or firearms, I think it's really important to always have the knowledge on how to operate a firearm, you know, effectively and really safely is the most important thing. Because you never know when you're going to come across one, when something might happen, when you're going to be around a firearm, have to use a firearm, or someone's going to try to use a firearm on you, and you need to know how to operate that. So when I asked a friend of mine, who used to be in the armed forces, to show me how to shoot a gun, he was pretty excited. And so I've got some footage of the event, and I want to show you what was like my first shooting experience.
Where'd it go?
I see the dot. You see the dot? It's right below the red circle. Nice. Nice, right on the bullseye. That.
It's a big S.
Somebody's dangerous now.
S for science.
Nice. I like it.
I got one in the middle.
I think you broke the middle three times there. Yep, you're out.
Okay.
Yeah. Give it a little tug and let go. There you go. Nice. Okay.
Awesome.
Wow, dead center.
Excellent. Nice.
Wow, you're drilling it. Let's see. So that was first time, but I mean, you get some good center hits, right? Your second time. Excellent.
So I gotta pull this thing down.
Yeah. All right, so this is a slug. Remember, get this up a little bit higher so you're into your shoulder. Yeah.
Yes! I totally
went. You went a little high.
Yeah.
Should we try that again?
Alright.
Load it up. Slide it in until it stops. Around the back. Now, aim a little low. There you go. Excellent.
I saw that glass like at the back.
A little bit harder freehand, isn't it? Now put in your magazine. Okay, that's locked. And so now hit the upper paddle. Okay. There you go. Now you're locked and loaded.
Okay.
Now you're dangerous.
Now I'm dangerous. I just put him in his arm.
You're being so unsafe. Okay. barely see the target on the screen.
Addicted. I'm not operating the weapons in an unsafe manner. I'm definitely being safety conscious. I was taught the four rules of operating a firearm, which are: number one, the gun is always loaded.
Okay, I'm the only one in this room professional enough that I know of to carry this Glock 40. I'm the only one.
Number two, never point the gun at anything you don't want to destroy. Number three is always know what's in front of your target and what's behind your target. And number four is never keep your finger on the trigger unless you're ready to shoot.
Marvin, what do you make of all this?
Man, I don't even have an opinion.
Well, you gotta have an opinion. I mean, do you think that God came down from heaven and stopped
What the fuck's happening?
Oh, man. Oh man, I shot Marvin in the face.
Why the fuck did you do that?
Well, I didn't mean to do it, it was an accident.
So I hope you enjoyed watching me shoot for the first time. It was a blast, it literally, and it was a lot of fun. And you know, I feel a little bit more confident, and I really feel like I have a much more realistic and empirical understanding of what a gun is and how a gun operates. And you know, just looking on TV, you know, at people shooting guns, you don't really understand what a gun feels like in your hand or how it operates or how when you fire it, it recoils. Even though you can imagine it, it doesn't become really real until you actually do it. So it was a great experience. I recommend everybody try it if you want to, and if you don't want to, don't.
That's so cool.
Let's go see how you did.
Awesome.